Hi, thank you for watching my earlier episodes. In the science series, this is the second episode. It's on the second sign, that is the Taurus. The Taurus falls on the second house of the natural zodiac. It's known as Vrishabh in Hindi. The symbol for Taurus is the bull. This is different from the ram, that is the symbol for Aries. This is the bull. This picture is from the excavation of Harappan civilization some 5,000 years before. This bull was taken on the seals that was used for exchanging commodities, goods, and as a symbol of financial transactions. The bull was a very, very appropriate symbol because at that time, we didn't have grocery stores, we didn't have planes and computers and cars. People were farming and that was their main source of income. The bull was important for farming, for cows and carrying the goods. In mythology, he is very, very important. He is the vehicle of Lord Shiva and he is also the gatekeeper of his temple. As a matter of fact, the right way to enter Shiva temple is to ask him, whisper in his ears, the permission to enter the temple and then go in the temple. As we saw that he is the seal of Harappa. The second house in zodiac and the Taurus sign is ruled by Venus. The Taurus sign has one of the brightest stars and that is known as Rohini. This is also known as Alpha Tauri and Aldebaran. In Hindu mythology, Rohini is the most beautiful constellation that Brahma created. So much so that he became almost obsessed with it. And this is also the favorite star of the moon. Coming to the characteristics of the Taurus. It's an earthy sign because the element of Taurus is earth. It's a fixed sign. Fixed sign means there are three kinds of sign: fixed, movable and dual. So it is fixed. Fixed means the things take time to move. It's a semi-fruitful sign. There are signs which are fruitful, semi-fruitful and barren. When it is a semi-fruitful, it means that we can look at the answers in a positive way. It is possible that things will or the question will yield a positive result. The even numbers are negative numbers. As an animal, it's a quadruped and the night sign. Nocturnal is a night sign because we are away from the east. It's a windy sign and this windy sign helps you understand in the composition and the physical composition. It's a Rajasic. Rajasic means it looks for more comfort and it's a bit laid back and luxurious. It's a benefic sign. And it's a northern sign and Uttarayan are almost the same because that means the sun is transiting towards the north side. The places come very handy when we have to look for things or to find when we have to pinpoint a particular event where it can happen. In many ways, understanding the places is a big help. So cow sheds, cattle sheds. Why cow and cattle? Because again it's a quadruped, so that could be the hiding place or the living place. Furniture, it somehow indicates woods as well. And away from home, because this is it's a wanderer sign, so they like to be away from home. Safe deposits, because this is also a sign of finance. So safe deposits, banks, they become an important one of the characteristics of Taurus. Storerooms and granaries. A storeroom could be for anything, but generally these storerooms are places where we keep food. The height is in these kind of areas, the height is low, and there are also cellars, and many times these are those underground, lowly lit areas. The professions that Taurus indicates is jewelry and finance, art, hotel, cinema, luxury. Music. This all is very easy to understand because these are all Venus work. Venus as a Venus is controls lot of luxury things, and it indicates lot of dance, music, cinema, and love for it as well. The cement industry is also part of this. In body part, sorry, coming back to that, the food. Why the food? Because second house is the mouth sign. So you can also, when a Taurus comes in, you can also say the person is fond of eating good food, because again, Venus is ruling this house. In body part, it is neck, throat, chin, lower jaw, and vocal cords. The Aries was the upper part, and this is the lower part, but it does involve part of the neck. So neck will also slightly go in the third sign, but we do take neck in this. The countries are mentioned. There's also some cities are there, and as you can see, Persia, Cyprus, Poland, Malaysia, Ayodhya, Hastinapur. As we discussed earlier, most of these markings, these Kato marking, are all part of the earlier understandings of the cities and their names. Most of these have changed the names. The stones that are lucky, or the stones that are represented by Taurus, are sapphire, diamond, and emerald. Sapphire is can be white sapphire also, and it can be blue sapphire also. Of course, diamond, Venus rules, and emerald. But why emerald and sapphire? Because Saturn and Mercury are positive towards Venus, and they are helpful. In fact, in Venus sign, Saturn is always a benefic. Constellations. There are three constellations that fall under the sign of Taurus. First is Kritika. Kritika is in the 320 is part in Aries, and from 0 to 10 degrees is in Taurus. And comes Rohini, that is from 10 to 23-20 degrees. This the full star of Rohini falls under the sign of Taurus, and part of the Mrigashira, that is ruled by Mars. The Taurus just does not speak about Venus only. It also speaks about Kritika, Rohini, and Mrigashira. Rohini is a sign of the exaltation of Moon. That is why when Moon is in Rohini, it is like a double benefic. So these are the characteristics of Taurus sign along with its constellations. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe.